Back in 2018, I made a video that showed how to install a bootloader for using the STM32 blue pill boards without a serial adapter. If you already have that bootloader installed, please do yourself a favor and upgrade it with this guide. If not, well, a lot has changed in the last year and a half, so I'm excited to show you how to do it once again. Some of the best improvements are that no janky drivers are required, and it only uses 2 kilobytes on F1 boards. The upload process can be done with either a serial adapter or an ST-Link V2, and I will show you how to do it with both. At the end, I will also show how to use this with platform I/O, and I will also have some troubleshooting steps, so be sure to stick around until then. We will start by installing the STM32 Arduino core in the Arduino IDE. If you've already installed a core, please check and make sure it is the version that I am using here, which is the official Arduino core for STM32. My previous video used a different STM32 core version, which is outdated and incompatible with this bootloader. Therefore, you will still need to follow along, even if you are only upgrading from the last video. Without further ado, let's get started. Go into the Arduino IDE and select File, Preferences. Copy this URL, which I have in the description. Then, paste it into additional board manager URLs. Next, go into Tools, Board, Boards Manager, and search for STM32. If you have installed boards that aren't from STMicroelectronics, such as from Dan Brown, go ahead and uninstall them before installing the STMicroelectronics version, or just make sure you are using the STM boards. You will also need to install the STM32 Cube Programmer from this link in the description, so go ahead and download and install it. STM requires an email address to send a link to, so just be aware of that. If you are having issues with your install, such as it not starting, make sure Java 8 is installed and upgraded. If it still doesn't work, there is a command line version in the installation directory that you could use with similar results. Now to install the bootloader. Open this link in the description and download the latest release of the STM32 binaries zip file. You can also download hid flash zip and install the bootloader that way, but it is an unsecure exe, so I'll show you a better way. To start with, grab your adapter board, not with metal tweezers, and connect the ground to your STM32 board's ground. You can also connect VCC to your STM32 board. Just make sure it is connected to the pin you have the voltage set at. You can check with a multimeter to make sure that it is correct before connecting power. You could also just connect the STM board to USB power instead of connecting VCCs. Just make sure that you have a common ground connection. Next, connect TX on your adapter to A10 and RX to A9. Move the boot zero jumper to the one position and connect the adapter board to the computer. Then press the reset button on the STM32 board. If you are using something other than a blue pill, check your board's pinout and connect accordingly to the UART TX1 and RX1 pins. Make sure you connect TX to RX and RX to TX. If you want to test out your setup, you can go ahead and upload the Blink program from the Arduino IDE. Simply open the Blink program from File, Examples, Basics, Blink, and change LED built in to whatever pin your LED is on. In my case, that is PC13. Now go to Tools and select the correct board. I have a blue pill, which uses the STM32 F103 processor. So I'll select Generic STM32 F1 Series. In Board Part Number, I'll select Blue Pill F103C8. There are multiple flash sizes, but mine are 64K. If you are unsure, it will most likely be 64K, the default. For the upload method, I'll put STM32 Cube Programmer Serial, and I'll select my serial adapter's COM port. Finally, upload the code. If all goes well, you should see your LED blinking. Go ahead and press reset with boot zero still in the one position, and we are ready to upload. Go ahead and open STM32 Cube Programmer, which you should have already installed earlier, and click this arrow, which will take you to the Erasing and Programming menu. On the right side, you should see a green connect button and a drop-down menu next to it. If you are uploading with a serial adapter, select UART, and then select your COM port. You may need to click refresh to see it. Otherwise, if you are using an ST-Link, leave it on ST-Link. press connect. If all goes well, you should get a green light at the top that says connected. Now go to the STM32 binaries zip file you downloaded earlier and extract the files. Then in STM32 Cube Programmer, click Browse next to the file path input and search for your board's files in the STM32 binaries folder. I am using a blue pill, so F103, and mine is 64K flash space, so low and medium density. This may vary for your board, so choose accordingly. Finally, select the binary whose pin number is the same as your LED pin. In my case, PC13. The silk screen on the STM32 board should show the pin number right next to the LED. Finally, click Start Programming and wait for it to finish. If you used serial, make sure you move boot 0 back to the 0 position before you remove power, so that the bootloader is saved to flash memory on the STM32. And now, you should be done. From now on, you will not need to move the boot jumpers. Let's test it out. Go ahead and plug in the USB of your STM32. You may want to disconnect your ST-Link or serial adapter. Open up the Blink program in the Arduino IDE, and make sure the LED built-ins are changed to your board's LED pin number, and we are ready to test. Go to Tools and make sure your board and board part number are correct. Also in Tools, set USART support to Enabled Generic Serial, and set USB support to CDC, Generic Serial Supersede USART. You don't need to have a comport selected yet, as this method uses HID instead. Set the upload method to HID Bootloader, and click Upload. You should see your LED blinking. Once uploaded, it will actually create a virtual COM port that you can interact with. One more thing, go ahead and in setup add serial.begin 9600, and in the loop put serial.println hello world, and click upload again. You should now be able to see messages in the serial monitor. As easy as that, you should have a serial port that you can interact with. Now for some troubleshooting. If your STM32 ever freezes while uploading, or gets stuck on flashing firmware, try this. Re-upload the bootloader as shown before. Disconnect the device, unplug the ftdi adapter or ST-Link, plug in the USB cable, and click upload again. If it still shows flashing firmware without any progress, just press upload again while it's still stuck. This time it should work and your script should upload first try from now on. If it doesn't work and gets stuck again, repeat these steps. Sometimes it takes a few tries. If you get the error, device is not found, just unplug your STM32 board and plug it back in. Click upload and the board should be recognized. If this doesn't work, you may need to reinstall the bootloader, but it shouldn't happen often. Pretty soon, I will be making a video on how and why you should switch to Platform IO. If you want to use this bootloader with Platform IO, here's the config to use. I can't guarantee it'll work with the F4 boards, but I have tested it with the F103C8T6 boards. I can't claim to entirely understand why, but I know this works. Upload port shouldn't be necessary, but it complained when I didn't have it, so you should just set it to something. Upload protocol should be hid. When it's all said and done, you should have it working in PIO. If you're still having trouble, or want to join a community of STM32 developers, join our Discord with the link in the description. Work on projects, ask for help, and potentially see what I'm doing before the video comes out. Also, do not forget to subscribe. I have a lot of great projects coming up soon with the STM32, and you do not want to miss them. Thank you all for watching, and happy coding. I just want to give a big thank you to my Discord server. They did a lot of script review and testing, so I did not have to. Thank you guys. But big thank you especially to Neil and Finn. They went above and beyond. They discovered ways that I could fix things that were going wrong and just testing and stuff like that. So huge thank you guys.